Welcome to the Dojo Bush Center. I am Jesse Hammack, and today I'm going to be giving a lesson on the good and bad that Hashem gives us. Baruch Hashem, it's a beautiful, cool day outside. It's a nice, breezy wind. It's because for the last few months there's been hurricanes, hot, steamy. But at last it's finally cooled off here. Nice, it's like 61 degrees. Much, much better. Last night it was 50, and it will be 50 for a few nights. But yeah, let's begin. The good and the bad. So in life, you can either choose to do good or bad. And it's like a... You can choose to drop a rock on someone's foot, or you also could not drop a rock on someone's foot, or help someone that got a rock dropped on their foot. But, yes. Let's take the sitter here. Let's find Shema. Shema. One second. Bedtime Shema. Let's read. In the bedtime Shema, I'm not exactly going to quote it, I'm just going to do a brief overview. So basically, let's do a summary of the bedtime Shema, where it says, the Lord shall give you the land, the water, and your crop. The land, the water, the crop and the rain for your fields. And let me basically summarize this. And it says, if you do not follow unto my commandments, then you will not have the rain for your fields, and you shall perish from the good land which the Lord has given you. So, let's basically summarize that. That means that if you follow his commandments, follow them, obey him, and follow along his path and not go off on your own path, then don't think you need him. And he will take away the land. But if you follow him and obey his commandments, he shall give you the land, he shall give you blessings, he shall give you plenty and a good abundance of greatness. But if you disobey his commandments, he shall take away the good land and which he has given you. And you see, my family has been practicing Judaism for 10 years, but it was like 2 months ago we figured out we are actually officially Jewish descendants of Abraham. But here's the thing. Ever since the year I was born, we really started practicing. But last year's when we really started getting into it and heeding the commandments. This year we started the full Orthodox, but let me give you some basic commandments that should be followed. Honor thy father, thy mother, and the commandment about shaving the beard. Do not shave your beard if you have one. It's a great big mistake if you do, because the beard represents one of the 13 attributes of mercy, and it represents God's mercy. And when you shave it, you cut off God's mercy. And according to some accounts and some people that I know who've done that, they went through an extremely hard time. Things started falling apart, lost money, all that kind of stuff. So the beard... Do not shave it. I know that sounds like extreme or something, but trust me, it's true. And the Shabbat is very, very important, the day of rest. When he gives you, he's given us a day of rest from the week and all our work. And here's the thing. If you're going stir crazy because you can't do anything, it's called pick up a book, pick up the Tanakh, the Talmud, the Siddur, and study. That is something to do on the Shabbat. It's because that's all you can really do. And here are the basic laws of the Shabbat. You cannot cook. You cannot turn on lights. You cannot handle money. You cannot buy things. You cannot drive. And one of the, trying to remember the last thing. You cannot light fires as well. But, if you have a refrigerator that has an automatic light turn on, and you can find the little switch, I suggest before Shabbat you tape that. That's why you are turning on lights. And make sure you light the candles. I think it's either 18 or 20 minutes before sundown. But, and here's another commandment. You shall not put any other gods before him. Because in the text, in Article 1 of this book, Shemadi, it says, I'm quoting out of here, he says, it is written, there is no one else besides him. That means there's no other force in the world that has the ability to do anything against him. So yes, there is no one else besides him. And this is a very, very important commandment to follow. Because if you think there's something else besides him, that's kind of a problem. But, like, I'm trying to recall it. There's a lot of info to recall. Like, a graven image that's forbidden. And another important thing is to study his commandments. And study all his commandments, all 613. Because when you study all 613 commandments, you can get a full understanding of what you need to do. And on the subject of keeping kosher, we'll probably have to elaborate on that in a much bigger class, but let me just tell you the basics in class number one here. We have keeping kosher. No mixing meat or dairy. I suggest if you are eating meat, wait about 6 hours before you eat dairy. And here's another thing, you can't eat shellfish, pork, or fish without scales or fins. That's only animals that chew the cud and have split hooves. But, yes, and also here's another thing. When you're looking around in grocery stores, there's, even if you don't live in an Orthodox, a big Orthodox community where the grocery stores, great big synagogues, and all your supplies are needed, there's a symbol, an O and a U or a K or something with Hebrew writing on it. There's usually a little kosher section inside whatever store, like one has in Texas, that one in HEB, that one here in Publix in Florida, and they also have one at Whole Foods. And there's also, there's like a K, there's a scroll with a K. And yeah, these are the basic commandments that are kind of important to follow when you start following, when you start studying Judaism, or when you're just important commandments to follow in general. But I thank you for watching this class, and I will see you all next time in class 2 that will elaborate more on the commandments. And I thank you all for watching. Have a nice day.